When Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala anhu sits in one of the gatherings of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, discussing some of the affairs of the battlefield, some of the affairs of the war. So Abu Dharr gave his opinion, followed by his opinion Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, an ex-slave that Allah had honored through Islam. He objects on the opinion of Abu Dharr. And Abu Dharr is one of the Arabs. He comes from a respectful, noble Arab tribe. So when Abu Dharr saw the black Ethiopian ex-slave Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu saying to him, "I don't agree with you, Abu Dharr," Abu Dharr got angry. Abu Dharr got angry and he said to him, even you, the son of the black woman, want to object against me? Even you, Bilal? You are the son of the black woman, an ex-slave. You want to oppose my opinion? Bilal was shocked to hear someone from the followers of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam speak to him the way the Arabs used to speak to him in the Jahiliyyah before the Islamic era. He was shocked. There's no existence of such attitude amongst the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam and Muslims, of this stupid attitude, tribalism, thuggish mentality, thinking I'm better than you because I come from this tribe, or because I've got a gun in my pocket, or because I've got bigger muscles than you, or because I've got two tattoos on the side, or because I've got money, or because I've got people behind me, or because I'm loud. This mentality is not accepted in Islam. And when Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he's Abu Dharr speaking to him the way the Arabs used to speak to him before Islam, he was shocked. So he went to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. "Oh Messenger of Allah, one of your followers Abu Dharr spoke to me the way the Arabs used to speak to me before the Jahiliyyah. Does that exist in Islam?" And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not hesitate to stand with someone who has no tribe behind him, who has no money behind him, he has no people behind him, but he has Allah Azza wa Jal, the greatest, to go against someone like Abu Dharr, who is from the tribe of Ghaffar, a respectful tribe amongst the Arabs. So he went to him and he looked at Abu Dharr and he said to him, "Oh Abu Dharr, is it true what I heard about you? You're saying this and that to Bilal?" So Abu Dharr said, "Yes, O Messenger of Allah." So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam tells Abu Dharr, "Anta mru'un fika jahiliyyah." Oh Abu Dharr, you're a man till this day. Till this day, that mentality and the attitude of jahiliyyah is still in you. "Anta mru'un fika jahiliyyah." Till this day, even though it's been maybe 20 years of Islam, till this day you think like the ignorant people during the time before Islam, during the time of jahiliyyah. But yet, Abu Dharr acknowledged his mistake. Abu Dharr acknowledged his wrongdoing. So he went to look for Bilal. And from distance where he sees Bilal walking, Abu Dharr approaches him, puts his head on the ground and tells Bilal, "Oh Bilal, you step on my head. You step on my head so I could be taught. So I could be taught the lesson between the difference between Jahiliyyah and Islam." But Bilal refused and grabbed the head of Abu Dharr and kissed it, because that's what Islam teaches them. This is Islam. This is Islam. Humbleness between one another, respect with one another, grabbed onto the rope of Allah Azza wa Jal, and never ever divide or disunite.